Smoke still ahead here on Good Morning Arizona. We're learning about a great event happening here in the Valley that's helping women actually fight breast cancer, raising money for a great cause. So stay with us. We'll be right back.
You know what? It's a very special event going on, helping to battle breast cancer, and Tess is over there in the small studio for it.
Yeah, raising money for a great cause, a special event happening midweek, and it's going to help people, of course, just as we spread word about Breast Cancer Awareness Month, which is coming up in October. In Arizona alone, did you know that more than 4,000 women are diagnosed every year? So this morning, we're joined by Christine, who is with, let me get this right, I want to make sure I say it right, Christine Fenwick of the Arizona Institute for Breast Health, as well as Doug Wooster of Moet, because they're teaming up for Sapporo, a great event, the pinkest event in Scottsdale. Thanks for being here, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Let's talk about this, because it's happening on Wednesday, a party to kick off, and what folks can expect in October as you guys team up with Sapporo.
Yes, this is going to be the pinkest party that Scottsdale's ever seen. We're very happy and very excited about Sapporo's and Belvedere. On Wednesday, the 12th, it'll happen from 6 p.m. until closing. People are encouraged to come and enjoy, and there'll be sample drinks and some menu items that we're very excited about it, very excited.
Everything pink, of course, is the key here, and I know that's what you're going to be making, Doug. I'm going to let you get started. Tell us about what you're making, then I want to learn more about what you guys do with your organization, Christine.
Well, the first one that we went ahead and made this morning, pre-made, had to taste a little bit, you know, to make sure it's good. It's the pink geisha, and it's actually our take on the black raspberry and mint.
Ooh.
And a little bit of grenadine I always like to add because of the flavor. And then this one is the pink geisha, which is a Cosmo, basically.
It looks like a Cosmo. Mm-hmm. Okay.
And it's actually really nice, a little bit of sweetness. I like to sugar the rim. You can find this in particular, this is Stirrings, it's Cosmopolitan Rimmer. And what that does is it just adds a little kick, a little sweetness, and it actually has dried cranberries in it.
Ooh, that sounds delicious.
Good.
Taste, I haven't tasted, people. We're just looking. And what are you going to be making next for us?
This is actually the pink geisha. I went ahead and started it.
Oh, you started,
Because it's a little difficult. So you're going to want 4 basil leaves, approximately 4 strawberries. You're going to muddle it in a glass.
Okay.
And then we're going to put it in the shaker. And shake it up.
It looks so pretty, the color.
Oh, it's so good. This is my favorite drink. It's really easy, and it's delicious.
Christine, I can't taste test because I'm still on the clock, so you might have to do that. Talk a little bit more about what you guys do over the Arizona Institute for Breast Health.
The Arizona Institute for Breast Health provides a second opinion for treatment options to recently diagnosed breast cancer patients. Each one of those patients is supported and lovingly guided by a patient advocate. And actually, I'm a 17-year survivor, and I touch each patient that comes through our program. The second opinion is awesome, and it's provided through our multidisciplinary panel of physicians that donate their time each week to the Institute. Once a week, they get together from all over the Valley, and they review these patients and offer them a very valuable second opinion for their treatment.
That is awesome. That's what we're raising funds for.
That's what we're raising funds for, so that the Institute can continue their mission, very, very vital mission in the community. We help thousands of patients have come through our program. We help their families. We help them find resources so that they can go about their treatment and understand what's happening, you know, while it's happening for them.
And being a nonprofit, donations, of course, are important, and that's why you guys have teamed up with Sapporo.
Yes.
The information there on your screen, again, it's this Wednesday coming up on the 12th to kick off the big event that's happening through the month of October.
Yes.
They'll be donating proceeds.
Exactly. They're donating proceeds to what we call the Pink Light District, and that happens beginning October the 4th. People can sponsor Pink Honor Lights. They can go to our website at www.aibh.org to sponsor lights in honor, in memory, or in support of someone that has been touched by breast cancer. And we all know a lot of people that have been touched by breast cancer.
Unfortunately.
So, yes.
And that's why I know Belvedere teaming up too and making sure
yes.
we get this word out.
It's important, and I think it's a great cause. And because it's local, it really does tie in the community. So that's one of the main reasons why we wanted to do this with you. And thank you so
thank
much
you.
For letting us share in this.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your support. We're very excited about all of it. So
I'm excited too. This is awesome. If you'd like to learn more, it's all on azfamily.com, that easy. And Christine will taste test at some point. So. Thank you very much, Doug, Christine. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.